you know, your ambitions for the future? Is it to turn pro and make a career out of it?
Yeah, of course. Like, this is not a hobby. This is my job. Even now, amateur, I'm not getting paid. This is my job. I want to be the best. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, that's what I want to do. I want as a career.
What boxers do you look up to? What do you base your style on?
Oh, man, my favourite boxer, my hero, Sugar Leonard. And Pino Whitaker, my best fighters.
And 10 years, I've not seen this for a while. And you know, it's just like memory lane. And you know, out of all them guys that was there in the gym, I'm the one who's fighting for the world title. I remember working harder than everyone else because everyone was turning pro before me, remember? And Pat was holding me back because I wasn't mature, like my body wasn't mature enough kind of for a professional fighter. And I was fuming because I thought, nah, how are these guys turning pro before me? So I had to work a little bit harder than everyone else because I had the gifted ability, but just physically, just didn't have the body frame really. And like I just said, look, now I'm fighting for a world title, which I'm going to win. It's hard work, dedication, and I signed up for it. So when I signed up for it, it's like I signed up for all the bumps on the road, on the way to get there. You know, some people don't, they say they sign up for it, but they don't. Because when something bad happens, or when something hard happens, they give up straight away. Where, you know, I signed up for it, done the blood contract, boom, put my thumbprint on it. And, you know, all the bumps and bruises on the way up, you know, deaths, close ones, John, my mum, you know, you knew my mum before me. All the bumps and bruises, this is a part of the journey, you know. And so I signed up for it, and look where we are now. We're flipping, fighting for the world title next week. So all that hard work, all that dedication, I even said it, tunnel vision. It's about having that tunnel vision, and look now, I kept that same mindset 10 years down the line. It's mad to think I was like 19 years of age I was. That one thing I'd tell myself back then, I have to say, believe in yourself more. Because I had all the gift and all the ability and all the swag up, but I used to not doubt myself. Yeah, I'd say doubt myself. I wasn't as confident as I looked. So I had it all, but there's got opportunities where I could have finished fights in round one. I'd see up the right the first round, get into it the second round, then win the third. Where if I just have that confidence straight away, boom, have a look, bam, 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 I'd be flattening them. But I was just a bit of a nervous person. Don't get me wrong. When it come down to fighting, I was on it, but like, just a bit of a nervous, like, anxious, you know, didn't really like to walk in rooms when there's loads of people because I feel like everyone will stare at me and, you know, just a bit. But then again, when I look back, I was still a kid. You get me, like, I was still a kid. But I tell myself, believe in yourself. Like, now I believe in myself. No matter anyone tells me, I believe in my ability, my own skin. You know, the guy I'm fighting is a good fighter, very good fighter, does what he needs to do. But I believe in myself. I know I can beat him, I will beat him. I believe in my own abilities. He's a good fighter, I'll put him on a pedestal. You know, and these are the kind of fighters you're going to fight at the top level. But there's no point not believing in yourself if you get to that level. I believe in myself, I back myself. I just tell myself back then, believe in yourself, man. Back yourself. Don't be afraid. Don't be worried about what anyone else thinks. As long as you've got yourself and you're listening, you know you're doing things right, you know, then don't worry. That's what I tell myself, just believe in yourself. A lot of greeting pulls because I remember the feeling, man. I was just nervous just being in the ring, being in a professional ring, vest off, little gloves. It was rammed as well. rammed.
Introducing to you firstly, boxing out of the blue corner, wearing the white glove shorts trimmed with gold. At the weighing, he scaled 10 stone exactly. One of British boxing's finest servants, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight is his incredible 203rd appearance in a boxing ring. Your appreciation, please, from the Neatons, Christian Lanes. And opposing him, boxing out of the red corner, wearing the black leather shorts trimmed with gold. At the weighing, he scaled 9 stone, 9 pounds. Tonight is his proud professional debut, hailing and presenting from Harper Hill, here is Delta Crown Flash Burn.
Just was, I remember just being nervous and thinking it's time now, this is time to your career, this is that time, nice start your career time, nice, you know, and think, yeah, you know, I was still like growing into myself then, still believing in myself then.
Oh, good shot, nice button, nice left hook to the body head then from Zelfa Barrett, that's it.
This fight is nice. Where I dig everything out, what I've learned all my career, since even on that video 10 years back. You know, there's going to be parts in this fight where it's going to be tough. It's going to be hard. But I'm ready for that. This is what we're in the sport for. This is why we train hard. This is why I'm at this position. I'm at the best of the best. Only the best of the best get to this position. Some fighters only get to British level, European level. I'm fighting for a world title, which I believe I'm going to win. I'm fighting at the best of the best, of the cream of the crop. So, you know, you're going to get put in them situations.
Action. Referee John Latham has scored the contest 40 points to 36 points for your winner on his proud professional debut, hailing from Harper Hay, Delta Crown Flash.